Hey, what's up you guys? Megan here. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing a quick little favorites video because one, I've come across so many great products lately and I really just want to share them with you guys. And two, we are in the midst of like a 2 week long spring break from UVA. I just found out today that we basically get another week of spring break and then classes are starting online for the next like month. I have some time to kill. Figured I'd film a video and share with you guys the products. I have some time to kill, so I figured I'd show you guys some of the products I've been loving lately. Most of these, besides the clothing items, are actually really inexpensive, so happy about that. Of course, love a good deal. I really hope you guys enjoy. If you guys have any favorite products of the moment, definitely leave them down below. I would love to hear. Love to try out some new products for the next month or so when I'm still home. If you're new, definitely subscribe down below because I'm going to be putting out a ton of new content now that I'm home and have a little bit more time to do so. So each week whenever I do my laundry, I swear I wash the same things because I wear the same things every single week. First of which is this top, which is a little dirty right now because it just pulled it out of the dirty clothes basket. Has some like black lint on it from the sweatshirt I was wearing yesterday, but it's this Free People top. You would definitely know it if you saw it. I'll insert a picture here of what it looks like, but it's like this off the shoulder flowy top. I have this in black and white and I swear I wear both every single week, at least once a week. My black one is a size small and the medium is definitely too big on me. The small is even a little too big on me, so like I would definitely size down two, I would say, because I'm usually like a medium large. Definitely get at least one size down, if not two, which is because it's like very slouchy. It'll keep falling down your shoulder, which is fine until you put it on your shoulders and it won't stay. So I got this at Macy's actually, the black and the white, and they're originally $80 each, which for a top is like, oh my god, I can't even. I got them on some sale at Macy's, and so I got them for $40 each, which still for me for a top is like, what? I wear it every single day. It is great quality, so like I kind of get it, but still. Whew. Definitely recommend though if you're in the market for like an everyday class top, because I love to wear this with leggings, which is my next little category. So if y'all have been watching this channel long enough, you guys probably know I don't have a ton of Lululemon. I get the hype, but also it's like I'm the one who's buying the $100 leggings, so I don't always have like $100 to drop. But I will say I bought these In Movement leggings, also pulled them straight from the dirty clothes baskets. That's disgusting. Showed you guys I wore these yesterday. They're like this purpley color. I just love this color. It's very different, and I already have enough like black leggings, black yoga pants. I actually sized down in Lululemon leggings, which I've recently discovered when I went to go try these, because my Wonder Unders always fall down, and it's not like I've lost weight. Definitely not the case. I guess they're just sizing is different. So these are a size 6. I'm usually size 8. These are just great because they're a mix between, it's like an aligned texture almost, but like it's really tight in the waist. And so I will say it's like not always the most flattering just because it does have that tight waistband up here, but it's not so tight to where it's super unflattering, but they definitely stay up. My leggings have to stay up just because of how much I walk. I like to run in my leggings. So if they fall down, it's just not worth it for me. And especially if I'm spending $100, definitely should stay up. So I also love my P448 sneakers. I cannot stop talking about these, y'all. I am obsessed with them. These I got from Nordstrom Rack. They're $150 and they're usually $300, which they're definitely like designer sneakers. So like they are cheaper than getting a Golden Goose sneaker, which I just can't even fathom spending $500 on sneakers. So these were kind of like my happy medium. I love these and they're so worth it to me. I wear these once again, like multiple times a week. They came with white laces and they were pretty thin. And I was like, these need to be so extra. They need to be so fun. So I actually ordered these laces. They're like sparkly iridescent laces from Amazon. They've worked out pretty well. They're like really thick, so they just make the sneaker look better. I just like, I'm obsessed with them. So it's worth it for me. I purchased them myself, of course, like totally my money. So moving on to beauty, I was about to buy, you know, the Moroccan oil that's like $100 or whatever, because my hair is getting really dry, really brittle. It looked really bad. Then I was at Trader Joe's and I saw that they had argan oil, and this is like 100% argan oil. I want to say for this entire bottle, it was like $7, which is insane. And that's about like what you'd get for like 35 or something from this Moroccan oil brand. And I've been using this at the end of my showers. And then I like brush out my hair before, flip my hair over, run this through my hair with my head flipped over, and I scrunch my hair, and then I flip it back over, scrunch it again, and then I don't touch it. And then I wake up in the morning, I have great curls. Who knew my hair could be so curly? I swear, maybe I'll insert a picture here. I think it looked really good just because it was less frizzy and just more like curly. And I thought that was definitely a good look for me. So I really really like this so far, especially if you want to moisturize your hair but you don't want to spend so much money. Highly recommend going to your Trader Joe's and checking this out. Since I thought I was only going to be home for a week, I brought makeup wipes, but usually when I'm back at school, I use micellar water. I just bought this from Target, put it on a cotton pad and take off my makeup. It definitely feels kind of oily, which was definitely a change because that's not really how my face feels after I use a makeup wipe, but I go back in and like wash my face after that and it feels really nice. I just feel like my skin's really clean and I've been liking to mix that with like an eye makeup remover, and then I just feel like all my makeup's really off because honestly the wipes are good when you're in a pinch or when you come home like a night out or something, but like if you actually want to do a skincare routine, highly recommend the micellar water. Another thing that I've been obsessed with over break is depilling my clothes. This is from Conair and you can order it off Amazon. I want to say it's $10-$15 and it looks like this and you just turn it on. And basically there's like a blade underneath here and it gets rid of those little pills on all your sweatshirts, on your sweaters, on your shirts. Like I have been addicted to using this. I used it on my dad's Life is Good t-shirt and my parents were so convinced that they bought one. So this just came in the mail today, which reminded me to film this favorites video because I've been wanting to talk about this. I could go on and on. This is amazing. It's also so fun to do. I literally watched like the entire season of Grey's Anatomy and like just did this on all my clothes. I have a couple sweatshirts and stuff that just like peel really easily. So this really kind of brings new life into those things and just makes your things look brand new. It makes them feel really nice. Another random favorite, but something that's very important to me, are good pens, because I write a lot in college. A lot of my professors this semester for some reason make us write all of our notes by hand, which I hate that just because I'm a slow writer. You can't like reformat it easily, obviously, because you're writing, but this pen makes it so much better. This is the Pilot Precise V5. I just love how this pen glides across the page. It is fantastic, it makes me wanna write, so definitely great for all my classes, and they're relatively inexpensive too. And then my last favorite at the moment is my Yeti coffee mug. I am obsessed with this. I guess it's technically not a coffee mug. I don't have it here with me at home because I drink coffee out of it normally, but it's just like the 20-ounce Rambler. I will insert a picture here. It's like the classic one, not the big one, but the smaller one, and it actually has a slide top. It's a magnet, so you can take it off and wash it really easily. I just love this for coffee in the morning. It keeps everything really warm, and then you can also transition it to, you can put like ice water and stuff obviously in there the rest of the day. I just love using this. I like that mine's white. I do work at a place where we do monograms, and so a lot of people engrave their Yetis. I think I might engrave mine just to stake my claim over my brothers here, because we all have our own Yetis. So yeah, that's something really cool that I think I'm gonna do soon. But anyways, that was such a tangent. Hope y'all enjoyed this like really random video. Definitely a lot more of these coming your way though, because I'm going to be home for the next week, month, year, who knows. My life's in shambles, it's cool, but at least I have a video coming. So anyways, if you're new, definitely subscribe and I'll see you on my next video. Bye guys.